Hey, what's up, everybody? Scott Zlatev here, and I'm outside enjoying the sun. You know, and most of you guys who know me, when the sun comes out, shirt comes off. That's just who I am. So you got to bear with it. But you know, I'm out here. I'm getting ready to. I've been kind of doing some work. I need to figure out how to screen this a little bit so that I can actually do some work out here. But it's a beautiful, gorgeous day outside. And you know, last night I was, or it was actually this weekend, I had my daughter, and I was, she saw my medal. Now, a lot of you guys know who follow me, or have been on my list or anything like that. You know, I entered a physique competition, and yeah, let's go inside here real quick so I can talk with you because there's all this racket going on. And I also want to show you something. My daughter saw this medal that I won entering a physique competition, and you know, she was really impressed with it. She's like, "Good job, Daddy." You know, she's so proud to know that Daddy got a medal, and now she wants medals and she wants to win awards and stuff like that. And she said, "Well, do you have any more?" And I really hesitated to show her all the different stuff. And I said, "Well, yeah, Daddy's got a lot more. They're downstairs in the box. Would you like to see them?" And she said, "Well, yeah, I would." And I said, "Well, you know, it was almost time for bed, so I couldn't, you know." I was like, "Well, I'll show you tomorrow." Well, she never said anything about it, so I didn't show her. So next time I'll show her, because I finally actually pulled it out of the box. All the different awards and accomplishments that I've had over the years. And here's a fascinating thing, and I'm going to show you this, and this, again, guys, this isn't to brag, this isn't to boast, anything like that. It just kind of shows through my life what I've kind of accomplished in different areas, from sports to academics to, you know, to marketing to, I mean, just all across the board. And it's fascinating. I'm going to tell you about the reason why I finally pulled these out of the boxes. Okay, so I gotta probably adjust the screen here. So I just decided to put these up on the mantle. You see, I got stuff from you know, from back in high school. You know, and this was back in my younger days. You know, state, you know, two in state track. It was on the relay team. All these different plaques and awards for, you know, most improved. Yeah, there we go. You know, so here's a really good example. Most improved. Why is it that I was able to get all these different awards? Well, it's because I worked all the time. I always focused on what I wanted to accomplish. That was my main focus. Was I set a goal? I set something that I wanted to do, something I wanted to accomplish, and I just totally focused on that. Right, that's how I was able to place 7th out of 15 people in a competition for the physique category of you know, men's bodybuilding, being completely brand new, not knowing anything what I was doing, and talking with several different competitors. They had been training for this thing for like 4 to 6 months previous to entering the competition. They knew 6 months ago that they were going to enter this competition. Well, I made the decision 2 weeks before. Now, granted, I've always been in decent shape, and I just had to tweak a few things to really get my body to where it needed to be on stage, right? So, so back to here, you know, I got stuff, you know, but just old stuff, you know, back when I was in you know, baseball. I don't even play baseball. I hadn't played it since a long time ago, but you know, all these different gold medals from track. You know, and then this one was my first marketing award that I ever won. You know, this one was the one that I was the most proud of. It was the all-around athlete that I got, you know, when I was a senior in high school. You know, I got stuff from Boy Scouts, you know, all these Pinewood Derby stuff, you know, and, you know, diplomas, all that stuff. And here's the medal that she saw, right? And, you know, honor cords, everything. Well, here's the thing, guys. I had all these different things in a box for many, many years. And the reason why I had them in a box was because I was almost ashamed of them. Because I wanted people to know me for me, for who Scott is, not for the stuff I was able to do. not for the accomplishments I was able to create in my life, and not because I'm all, you know, all that in a bag of chips. I didn't want people to be intimidated by me. I didn't want people to look at me in a different way. I wanted people to know and be happy with being around who Scott is, right? The real me. And so I almost threw all that out, you know. I went through some different challenges with some of my successes, and especially the reactions I would get from people. And some reactions were positive, but most of them were negative. You know, I went through a big process over years. And what I learned was that when I surrounded myself with the right people, they wanted me to do better. It's amazing when you start surrounding yourself with the right people, they encourage your success. They bring more success out of you. They say, go for the moon, go for the stars, shoot for as high as you can, and we want you to, and we wish you all the best, and we're there to support you. You know, we love you, we care about you, and we want nothing but great things and great success for you. You know, when I started surrounding myself with positive people who are geared the same way, who really want you to succeed, they want everybody around them to succeed, because they understand abundance is everywhere, abundance is everything, and it's the lack-minded and the poverty consciousness that allows people to start talking things in a jealousy type perspective and try to, you know, downgrade you because you became successful or you're succeeding at something, you know. If I were to drive the Mercedes I paid cash for back to my hometown and start showing, you know, anybody there and not even talk about it, they would automatically form an opinion of me again, like they used to, you know. And they're, you know, some of them have changed, a lot of them haven't. Last time I spoke with any of them. But, you know, the biggest thing is when you surround yourself with the right people, they bring stuff out of you that you didn't even know that you had. You know, one of my biggest mentors, Dave Wood, if you're ever watching this, buddy, thank you so much. Love and appreciate everything that you do for not only me, but the whole entire marketing community and every person that I know, even people who aren't actively promoting what it is that you have, you know. You've had a positive influence on so many people. And, you know, my birthday's coming up, you know, at the end of May, and a lot of people who are on my list, you're on my team and in many different ventures, online ventures, you know, I kind of have this, I have this tradition that I do on my birthday, and maybe on an unconscious level, that's why I pulled these out. Because what I do right around my birthday every single year is I do a lot of inner reflection. I look at where I'm at in my life. Am I happy in certain areas? Do I need to improve in other areas? Things like that. And you can call it midlife crisis or whatever you want to call it. I personally don't think it's midlife crisis, but, you know, it started out when I was 30. And I just, you know, I just looked at my life and I was like, you know, am I really happy? Do I need to make some changes? All this stuff. And when I was 30 years old, it was a resounding, I am not happy with anything. So I had to make some big sacrifices, some deep changes. I completely cut off all ties with every single person that I associated with. And I started from scratch, from zero. And I rebuilt who Scott was to be the man, the person that I truly wanted to be, because some of the things I did in a previous life, you know, some guys would say, yeah, way to go, Scott. And then, you know, but at the same time, it's not all that cool. So anyway, I just wanted to share this with you because, you know, my daughter, you know, brought it up, and I was just like, you know, and today I was just outside. I was, you know, doing some work and, you know, catching up on tan again. When the sun comes out, shirt comes off, So that's pretty much the next 3 or 4 months. I'm going to have my shirt off a lot, cutting videos and stuff. That's just who I am, you know. Might be a tank top, just to cover up. But, you know, the biggest thing, guys, is, you know, the reason why I was able to accomplish all that different stuff, and that's not even including, you know, what, I mean, that's not including any of the stuff that I've done on the internet. That's just kind of previous life stuff to kind of, I don't know why I've kept it around. It's been in a box, you know, it's not really who I am, but at the same time, it kind of shows where I started, where I am now. And the biggest reason why I was able to accomplish those things is because I focused, right? I focused on what I wanted to achieve. And I didn't let anything stop me. If there was something that came in my way, I would just hammer through it. I would do whatever I had to do because I wanted that end goal, right? I remember there was one thing I wanted. The very first medal I ever got was, this is actually kind of funny, because I was back in Weeblos, right? There's Boy Scouts, there's Cub Scouts, Boy Scouts, and Weeblos. Weeblos is like the inner, you know, the middle one, right? So I was in Weeblos, and when there was this one medallion that I wanted this medal. It was really cool, and it was a something God and faith type thing. Well, I never went. I spent 2 days in church when I was a kid. I'm not a religious person, but I wanted this medal. So I was like, okay, what do I have to do to get this medal? This is just, I mean, I just, this medal was just so cool. So I was just like, what do I got to do to get this medal? So I'm like, okay. So I read all the different stuff, and I went through all the studying, the research, the interviews, everything. I did everything that it took, and I got that medal in 2 weeks. And I, you know, it was supposed to take like, you know, 6 weeks or something like that for you to get the medal. But no, I wanted that medal now. So I just put everything aside. You know, my friends wanted to play. I'm like, no, I got something I got to do, right? And see, this is the type of focus that I have. What I bring to the table, and my team can attest to this, you know, anybody who's been involved in any entrepreneurial endeavors that I have, you know, currently I'm building quite a few, got my own system, you know, I've got some that have been paying me for a while. There's a couple other ones that are coming out June 1st, they're launching. There's one called LSN, there's another, iPass 2 is coming out. So if you don't have iPass 2, you better get with the program and get on board. Message me for, you know, just send me a message, and we can chat about, you know, any type of business stuff that you want to chat about. I've been, you know, talking a lot lately, and chatting with a lot of people on Facebook here lately. Just some different tips and different things, because I've had a lot of people come to me. And that's another thing that I'm probably going to do in the future, just so you know. I'm going to start, you know, answering questions live on Facebook, or, you know, in emails or something like that. In video, just to show you what I would do in certain situations, because I've got just a ton of different people messaging me all the time, asking me questions for guidance, you know, things that I'm involved in, you know, that they're either on my team or not on my team, or they're in something else and they want some suggestions and some different guidance and what I would do in certain situations. So I'll be answering different things over the course of the next few months. I haven't put together really anything. It's just something that I kind of come up with. But, you know, the biggest thing, guys, is that I focus. When I work, I focus 100% energy and attention on that. Now, here's the other thing too, is I don't always focus for long periods of time. Okay, I learned this from David Wood. You can't do that. You focus for about 90 minutes max. Is what your mind can actually focus on one specific task, right? So what do I do? Well, you know, I'm adjusting the water outside. It could be a 10 or 15 minute break. You just kind of break away, you break state, you go away from your work for a little bit, right? Then you come back and you focus, right? So for somebody like me who eats every 2 to 3 hours, you know, I could work for 90 minutes, go outside, change the water, something like that, grab a bite to eat, and then come back and do some work. Or watch a video, or listen to some audios, or something like that. You know, go for a walk. You know, break it up, break up your day. This is if you're full-time, right? If you're doing this full-time. If you're doing this part-time, you're probably gonna be just hammering away at nights and weekends, and on your lunch breaks. That's what I did when I was doing this part-time. And you know, that's what you gotta do. You know, and that's the thing, guys. You gotta do what you have to do, no matter what it takes. You know, and for me, and now this is just me, I sacrificed a lot. I did. I put all out massive effort, total time and attention to what I wanted to accomplish. And when I got started with the right company, with the right offer, with the right products and services that were desperately needed in the marketplace, just like something that's coming, LSN that's coming out, June 1st. Some of those tools and services can roll right into whatever products or whatever offer it is that you're building currently. You know, I mean, it's a beautiful thing. But when I really, really got there, I was finally making more money than I was on my full-time job, and I could have actually quit my full-time job inside of 6 months with that particular offer, right? So that's what's, you know, kind of on the horizon, and that's what you could actually look forward to when you decide to take action and join any of my teams that I'm actually building right now. So, you know, just send me a message. I'm not going to include any links in this because I wanted this to be more of value and just kind of something that's been running around in my head on how I've achieved some of the things in my life that I've achieved, right? So, you know, just total focus, guys. And focus on what you're good at, and then learn some of the things that you need to learn and get better at. So anyway, I hope that you got some value out of this video. I hope that, you know, it changed your perspective in some way. And like it, leave your comments down below, and share it with some other people who might want to see this as well. All right, Scott's Lake Tiff here, signing out. See you later. Bye-bye.